Hello friends, welcome back to another episode of Engineering Today, and we're back with some interesting space updates again. Today we'll start with the F-22 demo over SpaceX Starbase, followed by the Starlink deployment plan gain support of the appeals court, and we'll wrap up with SpaceX's partnership with T-Mobile. Let's start today's update with a flyby of the F-22 Raptor team over the SpaceX Starbase. Recently, on the 27th of August, the F-22 demonstration team and a heritage flight team had visited the SpaceX Starbase and carried out a flyby near Starship and Super Heavy prototypes. According to reports, the demo team that had visited the Starbase had flown the Lockheed Martin F-22 Raptor fighter of the U.S. Air Force at various air shows all over the world, showing the bizarre aerial maneuvers of the aircraft. Sources state that there were two demonstrations of plane flybys. The first demo had been done at 11:40 a.m. Central Standard Time, while the second flyby took place at 1:22 Central Standard Time. While the first demo was entirely of F-22 Raptors, the second demo also included an Air Force Heritage Flight Foundation and a P-51 Mustang. Reports say that the demonstration team was in town to participate in the San Padre Islands Roar by the Shore Air and Space Expo. Just a couple of days before this flyby, the Air Force Heritage Flight Foundation had tweeted that tuna was ready for the Roar by the Shore. They wrote, "Who's ready for Roar by the Shore? Tuna is. Be sure to catch Heritage Flight's P-51 Bum Steer soaring through South Padre this weekend with the F-22 demo team." On the day of the flyby, the official Twitter account of the F-22 demonstration team stated in the morning that they'll visit the South Padre Island, Texas, and would have two demonstrations. The demo team's excitement was very high, they wrote. It was great to rocket past SpaceX. Report says that the demo took place a couple of hours before Elon Musk and T-Mobile CEO Mike Sievert announced the new partnership between T-Mobile and SpaceX. In our next update, SpaceX Starlink satellite deployment plan has gained support from the U.S. Appeals Court. Back in 2021, SpaceX had won an approval from the Federal Communications Commission, or FCC, for deploying 2,824 Starlink satellites in an orbit much lower than the planned orbit. After that approval, SpaceX has nearly 1,000 spacecraft operational in that orbit. But the FCC approval was challenged by competitors, such as Viasat and Dish Network. These challenging companies had also tried to block SpaceX's Starlink from using the 12 GHz band, even though the FCC had already granted SpaceX request to do so. But keeping in mind SpaceX Starlink's growing importance to provide satellite internet connectivity in war-torn Ukraine, and also proving its reliability in helping disaster relief, a U.S. appeals court has finally supported the Federal Communications Commission's approval of SpaceX's Starlink satellite deployment plan at a lower-than-planned Earth orbit. Report says that U.S. appeals court support to SpaceX over the challenges to the FCC's decision posed by competitors has come up within a short time after SpaceX and T-Mobile had publicized about their partnership on a project Coverage Above and Beyond. Let's move to our next update, where T-Mobile partners with SpaceX to provide service to mobile dead zones. In the context of the present world, network connectivity is the most wanted thing to remain connected with people globally. But still, in various regions of the world, the mobile signals never reached and became mobile dead zones. In the U.S. alone, these dead zones account for 500,000 square miles. And to put an end to this problem, recently, SpaceX and T-Mobile have partnered together to bring up a project called Coverage Above and Beyond. The aim of the project is to end mobile dead zones. On the 25th of August, in a recent webcast meeting held at SpaceX Starbase, T-Mobile CEO and President Mike Sievert and SpaceX CEO Elon Musk had announced about this technology alliance between the companies. Report says that T-Mobile phones will be connected to SpaceX Starlink satellites by the second half of 2023. Sources state that the two companies will launch a new mobile service that will be enabled by Starlink's second-gen satellites and T-Mobile's bandwidth. Musk said, "I think this is really a massive game-changer. In a nutshell, it's no more dead zones. The important thing about this is that it means there's no dead zone anywhere in the world for your cell phone." Sievert said, "That's incredible because it's a lot like putting a cellular tower in the sky, just a lot harder." Report says not only this project will end mobile dead zones, but also it will become crucial for areas damaged by natural disasters. Musk said, "Even if an entire region or country lost connectivity because of a severe hurricane or floods or fires or tornadoes, earthquakes, there's so many natural disasters. Even if all the cell towers were taken out, your phone would still work." During the webcast, Musk also talked about upcoming Gen 2 Starlink satellites. Gen 2 Starlink satellites are meant for Starship launch, but Musk said that if Starship's development is significantly delayed, then SpaceX will develop mini version 2 for Falcon 9. Regarding Gen 2 satellite antennas, Musk said, "They're the most advanced phased array antennas in the world, we think. The antennas have to be extremely advanced because they've got to pick up a very quiet signal from your cell phone. And you can imagine that signal's got to travel 500 miles and then be caught by a satellite that's traveling 17,000 miles an hour. And the satellites have to compensate for the Doppler effect of moving so fast. So this is really quite a difficult technical challenge. But we have it working in the lab, and we're confident that it will work in the field." Sievert said that for the coverage, a slice of T-Mobile's mid-band PCS spectrum will be integrated into Starlink satellites launched next year. Sievert also said that coverage above and beyond will enter beta stage by late 2023. Primarily, the services will remain confined to text, MMS, and some selected messaging apps in the continental US, Hawaii, parts of Alaska, Puerto Rico, and territorial waters. Musk explained that coverage above and beyond will provide a total of about 2 to 4 megabits per cell zone. T-Mobile will continue to work further with SpaceX to increase the range of services. Report says that T-Mobile is seeking to work with carriers worldwide for the services. They're calling on other carriers to offer reciprocal roaming with other carriers worldwide. SpaceX, too, favored spreading their Starlink direct-to-handset service beyond the borders of the United States. Musk said, "This is an open invitation to carriers around the world. Please get in touch with us, and we'd love to partner with you and enable this globally." According to T-Mobile, the Starlink-connected T-Mobile service price will possibly be free for T-Mobile's most popular plans. For low-cost plans that might not include coverage above and beyond, T-Mobile expects to charge customers a monthly service fee. The fee would cost far less than the fees charged by satellite connectivity services, stated Sievert. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comments section. This will help us to improve.